the lifetime, the shelf lifetime for the NAFTA certificate of origin, 4 years after the signature, right? 4 years after the signature. So exporter signs that, it was good for 4 years. Of course, this is not to be confused with the blanket, right, which is good for 1 year, right? You can have created a certificate of origin, but it's attributable to the specific product, right? And that specific product stays in the warehouse, let's say, for 3 years, and then on the fourth year, on the third year, it gets out, but just before it hits 4 years, it is good, right? If it overstayed like 5 years or something, then you're going to need to prepare a new certificate of origin, the way you know that is because you have to have a date as a field in the certificate of origin at the time of you sign it, right? Right there. So 4 year rule. Acceptance must not be confused with the, oh yeah, that's yes, that's the one that the 1520D. So recall that the main point here is 520D claim is the reason you want to do that is because you do not have NAFTA certificate of origin at the time you made an entry, but you still want to take advantage of NAFTA, so you have 1 year after the date of importation. So keep in mind of those various provisions. Remember those various rules that we had. So we've seen the 5 year rule for the record keeping requirement, 5 years from the date of execution for exporter, for 5 years from the date of entry for importer. We also have 4 year rule, remember. We have 1 year rule for the 1520D. Learn to attribute those various dates and time rule and to the particular context, because it's very easy to get confused once you cut up in the heat of the examination and the time pressure that builds up as you try to answer those questions. So no, an NAFTA certificate of origin shall be accepted by CBE for 1 year after the date of importation, that's 1520. 4 years after the date upon which certificate was signed by the exporter or producer, yes, this is responsive to the question because it tests you on that 4 year rule. 30 calendar days after the date of discovery. No, that's an error rule. We shall cover that in a bit. Let's see. 4 years after the date of entry. So this is where you have to know. Date of entry rule is applicable to that 5 year rule for the importer record keeping requirement. Not the exporter, but the importer. So when you see the date of entry, usually it is applicable on the importer side, not the exporter. So this one is incorrect. 5 years after the date of entry summary was filed by the broker. So well, clearly it tests you on a 4 year rule, right? By the exporter. 5 year rule, the broker has a requirement to keep entry summary for 5 years, right? So in a way it's true, but this is, it seems that, again, this is one of those best answer rule situations, because it can be the true statement. But look at what customs examiners are testing you. They're testing you on NAFTA. They're testing you on certificate of origin, not the entry summary. And it implies that you have the 4 year rule requirement, not the customs broker requirement. Because usually if customs examiners are going to test you on record keeping requirement attribute to licensed customs broker, they will either have it under the record keeping section of the questions, of the question portion of the exam, or the customs broker responsibilities, or sometimes they just call it customs brokers section of the exam. Yeah, that can be done. In this context, you can easily spot that it's not the broker that they're being tested for, it's the exporter requirement. It's the shelf life of the certificate of origin, which is 4 years after it was signed by the exporter. So B is the correct answer choice.